So we have the another method of classification, that is a presence of vertebral column or absence of vertebral column. So the animals in which the vertebral columns are present, we call such animals as vertebrates, and the animals without vertebral column, we call it as invertebrates. Okay. Next, snake. Let us see the example. Snake, birds, fish, and kangaroos are also humans are vertebrate animals. We are also vertebrate. We just now I told you that in the center of our back a vertebral column is there. So we are also vertebrates. Snake also vertebrate, birds also vertebrate, fish and kangaroos. Animals such as snails, cockroaches, earthworm do not have a vertebral column, and therefore they are the invertebrates animals. Okay. Now, what is the example of invertebrates? Snails, cockroaches, and earthworm. They are not having a vertebral column, so it is a so they are the invertebrate animals. Now, next one, name some animals which lay eggs, okay, and others which give birth to their young one. Okay. Now, which lay the eggs? Here only we have the answer, that is a hen. And which give birth to their young ones? We know human being. As well as kangaroos, it is also kangaroos also give birth to their young one, as well as the human being also give birth to their young one. Let us see, according to this topic, we will see the next criteria for the classification of animals. We have learned that producing another living things like oneself, it's called as a reproduction. You know the most important property of every living organism, that is a reproduction. But you know what, the animals, in animals, according to their reproduction, also two type of animals we will see in this topic only. A hen lay eggs and hatches them. We know that hen lay the eggs and hatches them. After a few days, what happened? The young chicks hatch out of the egg. From that eggs, we will get the young chicks. A cow gives birth to a calf. We know cow gives birth to a calf. And before that, the calf grows within the cow's body. So, according to the mode of reproduction, animals are classified into two types, namely oviparous. Ova means egg. Okay, oviparous means egg-laying, means which gives eggs, which lay the eggs. See here, meaning also given, oviparous animals means which lay the eggs, and viviparous animals which give birth to their young ones. They not lay the eggs. So, which the animals which give birth to their young ones, we call it as a viviparous, okay. So, the kangaroo is viviparous, the hen is oviparous. Next one, where are the animals, namely a horse, a bear, a tortoise, an alligator, a fish, a deer, and a frog to be found? Now, if the name of animals, it get changed, their habitat, means their living place also get changed. Okay, we will see them one by one.